Well, if it isn't the Great Hunter herself. As if you don't know, all four of the Cardinal Virtues lay low, all with your help. You're the talk of the stairs, Delara. When the Nye returned to Lakeland, we knew in our hearts that change was on the horizon. But never did I dare hope that you might help rid us of those terrible fiends. You surpassed my wildest expectations.
Not mine, Glenaud. Aye, when I first laid eyes on her, I had an inkling that she was the hero we've been waiting to come along.
Huh. Easy to claim after the fact. If you'd indulge me, though, I would love to hear you tell how it all played out. The hunting of the virtues, that is. My word, there's so much more to it than I realized. And there I thought you'd only had to track down the bloody things. Gods, though, the things you learned about the Warriors of Light. So many secrets and details lost over time. And for all their hard work and sacrifice, they somehow brought about the Flood? Can't say I understand it all, but it's a bloody tragedy it is. We should gather the others and toast their memories. Heroes of Eld, brave and true, to be remembered forevermore.
Now, I'll thank you not to let your bleeding heart drive you to offer up a fortnight's stock of spirits. Attend to your other customers and let me speak with the hero of here and now.
Whatever would I do without your good sense and wisdom? Very well, I'll leave you to entertain her. But don't think we won't be having that drink someday.
Delara, I must thank you for sharing with us such incredible tales. It is only right that I repay you in kind. With the ending, that is. With the story of the true villain who towers above the virtues. The devil more deserving of death than any that yet lingers in this world. If your curiosity has been piqued, then meet with me atop the balcony, overlooking the crystalline main. I will be waiting there until you do. You came, as I knew you would. Never met a mystery you could leave well enough alone, or a demon that you could let live, am I right? And this demon is undeniably deserving of death. Make no mistake, to cut them down would be just and proper, the act of a goodly person, and that is just what you are, I can see that. No need to grow impatient, or be offended, my friend, but before you pass judgment on this villain, you need first understand their part in everything. Who they were to the fallen Warriors of Life, for instance. Of course, right about now you must be wondering how I know what I know. What a tavern wench of all people has got to do with any of this. Let me tell you then. I am the one who brought together the Virtue Hunters. I am the one who marked you as a potential ally to them and bade you join them in their quest. I alone knew what had to be done, and what sort of sinner would be needed to see this tale of tragedy and betrayal brought to an end. But come, we have many moms ahead of us still. To Calusia and the Codger's Crook, I will go on ahead and wait for you there. You are accustomed to life on the road, I see. As am I. Do you recognize this place? I thought you might. Here is where it began, where Ardbird first met Lamet. Still young, and lacking in experience, but possessed of so, so much potential. Heroes in the making, even then the keen-eyed could see. They would only fulfill that promise much later, though, after joining with their other dear companions, Brandon and Rhonda Ray. And one other, an elven woman, not half bad with a sword. But perhaps you're already asking the question, who? There were 5 warriors of light in all, but she would make 6. Indeed, after adding an Albert, there does seem to be one too many. But believe me when I say there was indeed a 6th adventurer lost to history, and her name was Siva. Though I doubt I need convince you of this truth, when you walked in the Virtue's memories, you saw her time and time again, did you not? Then you saw the true villain, the traitor responsible for all their woes. Let us continue the story elsewhere, to Amarang and the Fields of Amber. You saw the true villain's face in their memories, and I told you her name in Calusia. But what were her crimes, you ask? Hearken to my tale, and you will learn. Silva had joined the others before they first met Nalbert. After their party of 5 came to this place, they took on a commission to slay a powerful beast that had taken up residence in the mines. Said beast was believed to be the instigator of ever more terrible tremors, and so time was of the essence. But during their hurried search, they crossed paths with their future companion, then a competitor aiming to usurp their prize. After another tremor triggered by the beast trapped them all underground, they had no choice but to work together to lay it low. But to their dismay, even after its death, the earth continued to shudder violently. As the adventurers looked to each other in confusion, Nalbert strode towards the beast's body and grabbed hold of a curious stone, a stone brimming with untold ether that he had sought out that he might harness its potential to rescue a loved one lost to the rift. But so powerful was the stone that it warped the flow of the life stream. Its very existence was a threat, and so, when faced with the choice between one life and countless others, Nalbert wept and shattered the stone. He had held his comrade's salvation in his hand and cast it aside for the greater good. For his sacrifice, he was judged a hero, and in that instant, a warrior of light was born. In life, Nalbert was a pragmatic figure whose wisdom and sagacity were admired by all. Little wonder that in death he would retain his virtue. But as Nalbert mourned the friend he forever lost, the betrayer, Silva, looked on in silent contentment, for they had taken the first step on their path towards becoming heroes brave and true. His sacrifice had sparked the transformation, but was fuel for the ritual to come. What ritual, you may wonder? Fear not, all will become clear in time. Come with me to Ratika, to the Shisha Swamps. We must retrace the steps as they were taken to understand the depth of her treachery. This place, too, is familiar to you, no? From days recent, and long since past. After the events in Amarang, Arbert and his comrades grew in fame, spurring others to entreat their aid. The adventurers sought out greater and greater challenges, and, in pursuit of another, they came to Ratika. While here, the hunter, Rhonda Ray, learned that the notorious mark, Balam Quits, was near. And so, under cover of darkness, she slipped away from the others to slay the beast by herself. Like Nelber before, of course, you already know what her motive was. Balam Quits had robbed her of her fellow hunters. Only vengeance would redress the balance. Moreover, she would not dare risk the lives of her new comrades. So, terrified was she of the mere possibility that she might have to relive that terrible day. And so she faced Balam Quits alone, and would have surely died for it, had Ardbert and the others not arrived in time to help. Like Nilbert before, of course, you already know what happened next. For her love, her conviction, and her resolve was she chosen by Heidelin. And, from that day forward, Rhonda Ray swore never again to betray her comrades' trust, to share with them the triumphs and the tragedies, to relinquish the freedom she had once held in the highest. The bravest, most courageous hunter that ever was. That moment would define what she became in life, and in death. Her sacrifice would hasten the transformation, was fuel for the ritual to come. The betrayer Silva looked on, yet more satisfied. They were oblivious to her machinations, unaware that they were dancing to her tune. Their journeys continued, and so must ours, to Ilmeg and Liagia. As beautiful now as it was then. You saw it too, would you not agree? With the death of Balam Quits, the legend of Ardbert and his comrades had grown larger than ever. Thus emboldened, they came to the kingdom of Volbert. Volbert had long been troubled by what some had dubbed a magical plague, and has since found transformed into misshapen fiends that the kingdom's knights had no choice but to put down ere the contagion spread. Brandon had been one such knight. In his youth, he had served the princess Soldia faithfully, only to be cast out for a single mistake. Thus did he take to the road, where he met Ardbert and the others. Having grown stronger and wiser and more respected, Brandon felt it was time to return and redeem himself, and with the aid of his comrades he did just that. Tadric, the court mage, was unmasked as the mastermind of Ulbert's misery, and by disgraced knight's blade was he brought to justice. But, with his dying breath, Tadric cursed the Princess Saldia, sentencing her to a fate worse than death. At her behest did he raise up his blade, and for the sake of the kingdom, strike down his liege lady. With that single stroke, he forever changed, though nearly not in the way that was necessary. He stood at the precipice and almost forsook his compassion for unflinching judgment, but mercifully turned aside at the last. Thus did he find and embrace true justice, that which weighs law and heart together and strives for the greater good. 'Tis a long, difficult road from which many stray, settling for simpler moralities. But I would expect no less of the man who became Daiskasin. His sacrifice would strengthen the transformation. 'Twas fuel for the ritual to come. As her companions grew ever more powerful, so too did the betrayer, Silva. Bit by bit, they brought her closer to her goal. But it was not yet finished. To Calusia they returned, and so must we. Tamra and the next chapter of our tale await. Slowly but surely, the adventurers were fulfilling their potential. Word of their deeds in Volbert spread like wildfire, and their legend grew ever larger. But for all their success, the fledgling heroes would be forced to endure more hardship and welcome more sacrifice. They pressed deeper into the depths of Ratika, towards ancient Ronka. 'Twas there that the dwarf, Lamet, came to a crossroads, for in claiming the magic she desperately desired, she would be forced to renounce something equally precious. Dwarves are a reclusive lot, wont to withdraw from the outside world that their many traditions might be preserved in isolation. When the stone blight began to spread, they chose to lock away the afflicted and refuse to seek outside help. But Lamet would not abide this. She vowed to save her ailing kin, her sister among them, even if it meant violating dwarven law. With her newfound power, she returned and cured the sick, and for this, she was banished from the Council of Elders. This came as no surprise, for she had made her peace with it long before, when she stood in the ancient ruin and called upon forgotten unguardians to grant her forbidden knowledge. She knew that what the price would be. She had weighed her traditions and identity against the lives of those she loved and made her choice. Though it pained her terribly, and in ways only a dwarf could understand, and Hydaelyn, it would seem. Through hardship and sacrifice was a new warrior of light forged, a healer that knew more than any the value of a life, and would do anything to see it preserved, even in death. Her sacrifice would nearly complete the transformation. 'Twas fuel for the ritual to come. Very soon then, very soon. For Ardbert and his comrades had stumbled upon evidence of the larger design, threads linking together the desperate troubles of the realm. A name spoken only in whispers, the Shadow Keeper, a singular force sowing chaos and discord throughout Nordrond to an unknown den. If the Warriors of Light truly wished to save their world, then they would need to confront this villain amongst villains. And at the end of their exhaustive search, at the end of their struggle, who do you think they found waiting to welcome them with open arms? answer to that awaits us in Lakeland, our final destination. The villain yet walks among us, Delara, unknown and unpunished. Go on ahead and wait for me at Loxenloft. There are preparations to which I must first attend.
Damn you, Silva! We were comrades in arms! Friends!
That we were and that we are. Everything I said, everything I felt, it was all true. You mean the world to me.
You're the bloody Shadow Keeper! What in the hell was this for?
For you. For every one of you, to forge you into heroes worthy of her blessing, that she might choose you as her champions. A ruthless mage, consumed by the pursuit of power to save his friend no matter the cost, by his sacrifice a warrior born. A mournful hunter, scarred by tragedy, resolved never again to trust in others. By her sacrifice, a warrior born. A disgraced knight who yearned to steal his heart in justice's name. By his sacrifice, a warrior born. A troubled healer, torn between tradition and love. By her sacrifice, a warrior born. And their leader, an adventurer with a heart overflowing with love for his dearest comrades, who must now bring his axe to bear against his own. By his sacrifice, a warrior born. I am the villain you seek, the keeper of shadows from a world shrouded in dark. By our struggle will this world be shattered and its souls saved.
Silva! Uh-huh. That was cheesy.
Saw it all, did you? I thought you might. Mother's gift has a knack for showing us exactly what we need to see, if not what we want to, or when. They knew me as Silva, but my real name? It doesn't matter. Like you, I am not of this world. I crossed the rift and came to the first. My home. The 13th, fell to dark in a calamity that mirrored the one which nearly claimed this world. I was one of several heroes who failed to save it. In our despair, we heeded the words of the Asians who came on to us. Thus did I choose to come here and, that I might redress the balance, hasten a rejoining of worlds. A shard subsumed by dark demands a mirror of blinding light. Primordial forces will strive to achieve equilibrium. But there was a solution. A single solution, I believed. Were a flood of light to consume the shard in its entirety, it would be of no use. The Asians made it clear it must be brought to the brink, but no further. The task was difficult, but the plan, simple. Souls predisposed to light, fledgling heroes in the making. I would bring together Ardbert and his comrades and groom them for a higher purpose. I would play the part of comrade and guide their course, all the while laboring in secret to pit stronger and stronger enemies against them, until finally, once they were warriors of light brave and true, I would reveal myself as a warrior of darkness and extinguish their radiance forever. Thus would this world be primed for a rejoining and the source for calamity. The Asians who called themselves Mitron and Lagrif were confident it would succeed. And indeed, Ardbert and the others rose to the occasion, as I knew they would. It was not to be. I had misjudged Ardbert. His comrades before him had made their sacrifices in turn, and as their mirror, I had grown stronger for it. Had he but embraced his role and struck me down, victory would have been mine. But Ardbert, dear Ardbert, would not forsake his heart. In the end, he chose mercy, he chose love, and I was undone. The rest you know. He sought out Mitron and Lagrif and granted them what he refused me. They accomplished everything they set out to achieve, and then the flood came and washed it away. In the wake of my betrayal, I will look on from the shadows and reflect on my many sins as all fell to ruin, denied death then and now, and perhaps ever after as a fragment of my essence endures. But then, one day years ago, my fallen comrades rose again as the cardinal virtues. It coincided with the arrival of the first scions, I later realized, a defense against the forces being marshaled to undo my failure. I can but assume the Asians planted the idea in Valtteri's head. They were his creations, after all, and with their graves in Yarmorian territory, it was doubtless a simple matter to have their bodies exhumed and prepared. Who am I to speak, you may think when I say this, but when I saw these abominations he had wrought in their image, I was filled with such despair, such anger. I cannot unwrite the past. My soul is stained with black as sin, and I will not pretend that I can ever be otherwise. But this act, this I could not ignore. If the Asians were going to such lengths, then surely others would cross the rift in due time. And so, I hatched a plan. I would assume the guise of Helia, and as her, take up residence in the Crystarium, where I would take measures to bring together the most ambitious of adventurers, individuals driven by more than mere coin, virtue hunters. That way, when the enemy, the Asians, feared more than any came to the first, the stage would be set. They would join in the hunter's quest, and together unmake Valtteri's Simiraqua and lay their souls to rest once more. And so you did, Delara. The virtues are no more, but the one ultimately responsible for their creation, the devil who set them on their doomed path, lingers still. You know all there is to know the heroes who saved this world. The truth I kept hidden in the shadows is yours, and there are no more secrets to share. And so I ask you now to grant me that which Ardbert cannot. Death. No, don't do this. Don't you spare me like he did. How can you stand there and say I deserve to live, knowing everything I did, the lives I destroyed, the chaos I wrought? The warrens pale in comparison, Surely there is no greater villain than the Shadowkeeper.
"'Twould be for my own benefit, that I cannot deny. And if I'm to indulge in one final act of selfishness, you'll make me do it myself, won't you? Make me confront the cowardice of it, the ugly truth that I'd rather run away than try to seek atonement."
Perhaps. Perhaps I have yet found my purpose in preserving my comrades' legacy, and helping others to understand the sacrifices that made them true heroes. For now, I shall return to the Crystarium and continue to assist Glirnard, while spreading the forgotten tales of the Warriors of Light. You would have been good friends, you and Albert, in another life. Maybe you and I as well. I tell you, I'm not at all accustomed to wearing armor any longer. Simply moving in it is enough to tax my strength. And fighting? Ugh. Any one of Captain Lena's recruits could probably put me flat on my back. Fortunately, I needn't rely on my sword to spread the truth of my fallen comrade's deeds. Only words in the passage of time will see their legacy redeemed in the eyes of the people. Thank you for accompanying me on my journey of remembrance, Alara. May your deeds ever be remembered and celebrated, as all heroes deserve.